three 100-yard rushers to running back in the game. What's that feel like? Is that something you guys would have expected to happen?
So like before the game, well, this morning, you know, we just we broke off on like 500 because like, you know, that's what we wanted to get. But, you know, just to see everybody get 100 yards, it just make a, you know, make me proud. You know, seeing Rodney score too, make me proud as well. So like seeing everybody get their burn and seeing everybody get their touches, it just makes us proud. And like nobody's selfish in this room. And like we want to see everybody eat and get to the next level. So it's just like something in our room that we don't have. I mean, it's something in our room that nobody else have. So that's the most I can say about that.
I mean, I'm extremely grateful, you know, be a part of that. And I'm thankful for these guys and the whole line. You know, we couldn't do it without us and the whole line, you know, the whole team, honestly, even the receivers, everybody contributed. So, you know, I'm proud of the team and just really proud to see all the hard work that we put in pay off, you know. So we've just been working hard every day and encouraging each other in a positive way. And just, you know what I'm saying, just taking every step forward. So,
Kurt,
I know there's been a lot of talk this preseason, kind of with the fans, of like how are those running back groups reps going to be split? There's three of y'all. How's tonight's game show you? I mean, it doesn't have to be about splitting. The kind of everybody can kind of get theirs.
Yeah, well, we kind of expected that, you know, sharing the ball. You know, usually it's whoever like had a hot hand, but today everybody, all of us had the hot hand. You know, I just want to thank the O-line. You know, thanks. Thank the scout team from practice because they've been giving us great looks throughout the whole week. So, yeah, that's all I got to say.
He covered that one pretty well for him.
Going to Matt.
This is for all you guys. How competitive are you with each other? You know, we saw that obviously tonight, being able to go out there and get those yards. How competitive amongst yourselves are you guys?
So, like, my with me, like, taking this leadership role, you know, I challenge everybody in the room, like, to be their best, you know. Before practice, you know, I'll talk to them, tell them, you know, let's be our best today, let's get better and whatnot, and, you know, we come out with a purpose. So, with that being said, you know, we just have that's the standard in our room. That's the standard of being the best, you know, earn that 1%. And, you know, it's just not us, you know, because, you know, it's all 11 guys going to be on the same page, doing the same thing, you know. You see what we can do with all 11 guys on, like, you know, through that job. So it's pretty much it, the standard in our room.
All right. He did say for all of them, so that's why.
I'm wondering if each one of you guys can describe the game of the other running back, or the two other running backs. So, Trayshawn, you can describe LT and Trey's game, and then all you guys take turns doing that.
All right, LT's game, he gonna give you a cut and he's gonna be explosive out of it. Very explosive. And he's gonna get up out of there. Trey Benson, he's powerful, speed, and he'll give you a 1-2. So like powerful and speed mixed together.
I feel like Trey, he a real very patient runner and he's very shifty. So you know what I'm saying? You know, you never know what you're going to get with him. You know, honestly, and he got some speed, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, he's just a jack in the box. You never know what you're going to get with him. But Trey, you know, he's powerful. Speed, he got everything you need too as well. And, you know, I feel like we all use our skills differently, but we all have a lot of the similar skills. I mean, like him being a little bit bigger, you know what I'm saying? His a little different, but you know what I'm saying? Everybody kind of like, we kind of teach each other as well, like, you know what I'm saying? Everything, like things that we do similar, we help each other with that. And like, you know, we just encourage each other in the best way we can, honestly.
Eight ball, I say he very patient. You know, I'm trying to learn how to be patient. So I'm actually learning from him to be patient because his patience is out this world. He remind me of Le'Veon Bell, and he shifted too. So he got a good spin move. It's crazy. LT, very explosive. He got a dead leg. He'll catch you slipping though. He always catch somebody slipping. It's crazy. So yeah.
Going back to Matt.
Again, this is for all you guys. I know it's a big win tonight, but you got LSU coming up next Sunday. How having this game on your belt, how is that gonna help you guys prepare to maybe give you a little bit of a leg up going against the Tigers next Sunday?
We're just going to continue to do what we did last week, you know, just another game, you know, preparing, let the scouts prepare us, continue to encourage the O-line, you know, continue to encourage each other.
We just trying to get 1% better each and every day, and, you know, just, you know what I'm saying, be able to play faster and more smarter, and just in each and every aspect, we're trying to strengthen anything that's a weakness or anything, honestly. We're just trying to be ready.
Going into the next week, you know, we're gonna always have respect for our opponents. So like, it's still another game. It's another game. You know, we still gotta prepare for like it's any other game, and just gotta take it day by day with the scout team giving us great looks and whatnot, and you know, being on top of the game plan that the coach is gonna be, you know, putting out for us. So we gotta come out there and execute the game plan. And, you know, be all as one. So you know, come out victorious.
Going to Corey.
Yeah, this is for Trey Benson. You guys next to you have made some big plays in their college career before and scored touchdowns. What did that feel like for you to get in the end zone, make a big play, just busting loose and getting to showcase the ability that you haven't really been able to showcase
in the last 2 years? I've been visualizing it for the past 2 years, so it meant a lot to me, you know. And, you know, come to the sideline after me scoring, them smiling, you know, they encouraged me a little more. But they actually told me it was coming. Like, they told me that I was going to bust one. And I was like, you know, I believe that, and it happened. So I'm just grateful for the opportunity to play with these guys and get better as a team and get 1% better.
All right, we're gonna go two more. Ira, or three more, sorry. Ira.
I don't know if you guys probably didn't know because you were in the locker room, but the students stayed the whole time through the rain, and then by the time you guys got back out there, it was obviously packed in the student section. What did they do for you guys, and what was the interest to buy from that section?
You know, I don't think we give enough thanks to the fans because, you know, being out there, you know, little do they know, like, you know, they're cheering, you know, when we're running down the field, you know, open field, like that. Like, when they cheer, they give a little, for me, it gave a little goosebumps and make me want to go better. So, seeing them stand out there through the rain, you know, and all that have going on today, you know, it shows a lot that they really care about us as a football team. And, you know, it really showed, like, you know, they're here for us. So, I want to say I'm thankful for the fans for doing that because, you know, with me, you know, rainy games, I'm not really liking the rainy games, but like that's some, you know, that's different. So thank you for the fans for that.
No, I definitely got respect for the fans, you know what I'm saying? We really appreciate it. You know, they really help, you know, bring that just that extra push, and you know, third downs, they're there for you, make sure you understand the situation and what the play that has to be made, and you know. It's just that little push, that extra push for us. We appreciate it.
It's most definitely an energy boost, you know. I'm thankful the fans, they have your adrenaline kicking in. You know, they make everything better, you know. They hype us up, hype the game up, and it's crazy. It's a really a dream come true.
Over here.
You guys mentioned, you know, you want to get Love's offensive line. You guys had some players, you know, shifting in and out all game with injuries. So what was that like, you know, to have the shifting offensive line and have, you know, still try to run the ball like you guys did?
I actually couldn't really tell, you know, because everybody was eating, everybody was doing good. So much respect to the offensive line, because I didn't even tell, I mean, I couldn't even tell they were shifting, like, you know, subbing in and out, I couldn't even tell.
I feel like they're kind of working like our group in a way, you know what I'm saying? Like, hey, the next man is up. We all prepare the same way, so everybody's ready for that moment, you know what I mean? So that's how I feel about it.
Yeah, he just kind of took my answers.
Last one's going to Austin.
For Trayshawn, it seemed like you really set the tone early. You were stopping some of the guys and breaking a lot of tackles and kind of getting more than what teams blocked out there. But then also, just want to ask Trey, like, how great is it just to get out there, not only get out back out there, you know, from the break of the engine, and you know, also make a lot of plays and, you know, go for 100 yards and do a lot of them.
I ain't gonna lie. Before the game, so I had the goosebumps, you know, my anxiety was through the roof. But, you know, I've just been, you know, keeping myself calm. These guys are keeping me calm. And, you know, I seen it coming. Like, I seen it coming from a mile away. I just ain't know when it was going to happen. But it happened today, you know. I'm living the dream, and I'm just thinking of the man upstairs.
We good? All right.
Thank you. Thank y'all.